In the first episode of our new live streaming series, Getting Started with Laravel on twitch.tv/sourcegraph, we've seen how to bootstrap a new Laravel application with Sailup and Docker. This allows you to develop your Laravel application using Docker containers instead of having to set up a fully functional PHP development environment on a local machine or development server. In this video, you'll see a recap of all steps that were executed during the live session so that you're able to reproduce them at your own pace. Before moving along, make sure you have Docker, curl, and Git installed on your local machine or development server. To get started, we'll create a new Laravel application using the official builder script. The first time you run the installer script, it will download a PHP image to run Composer and install the application dependencies. This may take a few minutes to finish. The installation script will also ask you to confirm your sudo password in order to set the correct permissions on the application directories. Once the installation is finished and the files are in place, you can then run Sailup to get your environment up and running. When running Sailup, you can include -d to have it running in background mode. The first time you run Sailup, it will download a few different Docker images to your local machine or development server, which will be used to set up the application services. This may take a few minutes to finish, but it will be much faster in subsequent runs. When the environment is ready, you can visit your application using your browser and pointing it to localhost. You'll then see the Laravel welcome page. With the Laravel builder script and Docker, it is possible to install and run a Laravel application without the need to have PHP installed on your local machine or development server. This can be very useful to explore the Laravel framework and the PHP language in general, with the additional advantage of using a standardized development environment that is compatible and optimized for running Laravel. In the next part of this series, we'll start building the front end of our project using Tailwind CSS.